now, DreamWorks Kung Fu Panda, Legends of Awesomeness.
Hear the legends of the Kung Fu Panda!
Doom, 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 boom, 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 boom.
Raised in a noodle shop, never seeking glory or fame, he climbed the mountaintop and earned the dragon warrior name. Ooh, ah, yeah, Kung Fu Panda!
Master Shifu saw the warrior blossom and master the skills of bodacious and awesome Kung Fu Panda!
He lives and he trains and he fights with the furious five. Protect the valley, something, 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 something alive. Kung Fu Panda! Legends of Awesomeness. Sweet!
Hey guys, it's Lamborox Strikes Up once again, and I hope you're having a good, and I hope you enjoy my Go Diego Go review. And today I'm going to review on Kung Fu Panda Legend of Awesomeness. Came out in 2011. As a matter of fact, it came out the same year as the second one came out, Kung Fu Panda 2, aka my favorite out of the Kung Fu Panda movies. So I'm going to explain the plot. So I think this show takes place after the first film or between the second one. Let me know in the comments where the show takes place. So, I haven't seen this show for so many years. The last time I watched the show was back in 2012 on Nickelodeon. Yes, when I first discovered this series, I remember I was browsing through the TV. There was nothing else I want to watch on TV. And there's not really that many shows I want to watch during that time. And I was browsing through the Sky Guide. I was looking for a show to watch. I was checking on what's on Disney XD, and they just basically played reruns of Phineas and Ferb. So I watched some episodes of Phineas and Ferb reruns until I found out on the Sky Planner that Nickelodeon is airing Kung Fu Panda Legend of Awesomeness, and I said to myself, oh sweet, a Kung Fu Panda TV show, sign me in, I love Kung Fu Panda. So I was like, sorry guys, just people walking in the background. So like I was saying guys, I had to stay in the shelter because it's actually raining in my area, so yeah. I was like, why not give it a watch? And when I first heard the theme song, I was like, what the hell is the what's up with the theme song? I will be honest, as a kid, I felt the theme song was a bit weird. You know, like, here's the legend of the Kung Fu Panda. I was like, okay, I'm not too sure if I'm going to like this show as much as I did with the first two movies. I was kind of skeptical at first when I heard the theme song. So I watched it anyway, and I was like, okay, this is decent. And I watched some more, and I was like, okay, this is actually not a bad series. I gotta say, this is quite a great show, and the theme song is actually great. The theme song was actually pretty catchy. So, let's get into the... I mean, I'm not gonna name the characters, because it's the same characters that we all know from the movie. So, I mean, there was actually an episode featuring the bad Poe and the good Poe and stuff, and that one, and I thought that was actually a good episode. And there's actually an episode featuring a character who's actually after the who's after Poe as the dragon warrior, and at first he started really nice, but then he wants to kill Poe, and because it turns to be dragon warrior, and he's trying to keep it a secret, but then it turned to be that one of the villains. And this show also features Tai Long's nephew in this series. Now I don't think I have watched an episode featuring Tai Long, but I know he's in the series. I think I may have watched this episode back when I was younger, but I gotta say Tai Long's nephew was a pretty interesting character. So I'm guessing this show might take place before the second film. Let me know in the comments what this show takes place. And the theme song? Here is the legend of the Kung Fu Panda. Yep, it's absolutely catchy. And if you guys have seen my Kung Fu Panda 4 cinema vlog, during the video after play the intro, I actually sang my parody of Kung Fu Panda Legend of Awesomeness. That's right, if you have seen my cinema vlog of my Kung Fu Panda Legend of Awesomeness, you guys probably know that I did a parody version of the Kung Fu Panda Legend of Awesomeness theme song. And yeah, you know my lyrics of that version. Here is the legend of the Lambo Rock Strikes Back. He works at Tim Hortons every single day. He likes Rick and Morty and Bob's Burgers. He even likes Futurama. Lambo Rock Strikes Back. Yeah, I forgot the how my lyrics goes in my Content Panda cinema vlog, because I haven't watched that cinema vlog for a while, and I did rewatch the full film. Now, if you have seen Know Me for a while, I'm going to do a recap of what I think all four movies. The first movie was an absolute masterpiece. It was an absolute pleasant surprise. I'll be honest, as a kid, I was not looking forward to that movie. I was actually not excited for the movie. When I saw the trailer, it looked like a generic kids movie. I was like, nah, I'm not going to see this movie in cinemas. And then I actually got it on DVD back then years ago. And after watching it, I absolutely fell in love with it. It was a great movie. It was surprisingly a great film. I loved the humor. I loved the jokes. I loved the characters. I loved the humor. And I loved everything about it. It was a DreamWorks classic. This is back when DreamWorks was a great studio. Nowadays, yeah, their films are getting hit and miss. Like Spirit and Tane and Boss Baby Family Business. That made me just lose, and even Trolls Band Together, that made me lose my faith on DreamWorks a few times, because I nearly, if you guys remember, I nearly lost my faith on DreamWorks after watching Spirit and Tame, and I nearly lost my faith on DreamWorks for the second time after watching Trolls Band Together, but thankfully, Content Panda 4 did kind of redeem the studio for a bit, even though the film didn't like it. But the second film is, in my opinion, is easily the best one in the series. I love the second one so much. I had a major blast seeing it in the cinemas. I even remember that my dad took me to go see the second one in cinemas back in 2011. And we had a brilliant time. The third film was a great film as well. But it was actually a great film. But overall, an enjoyable film. Kai was a decent villain, but he's no way as good as Tai Long and Lord Shen. But still a good film. And then we have the recent Kung Fu Panda 4, which came out recently. Now, I give it the same rating in my review. I did rewatch the movie on DVD back in a couple of days ago. If you guys know, I purchased the DVD at HMV. In my opinion, I will say that Kung Fu Panda 4 is the weakest out of the series, honestly, guys. Because my biggest thing about Kung Fu Panda 4, I'm not saying it's a bad film. I have some few flaws. Like, the story was weak. It's directed by Mike Mitchell, which I'm not the biggest fan of Mike Mitchell to begin with, because what he did to Chipwrecked was just not good at all. And I think Mike Mitchell was the wrong director of that movie. And I thought the comedian was a weak villain. She had a waste of potential. And I cannot believe they have to butcher Lord Shen and Kai, given no voice actors whatsoever, like WT, like what the hell. But despite that, guys, so overall, and the animation is still good. Overall, guys, I need to say this show gets 10. It gets 10 out of 10. It's amazing, brilliant masterpiece. Stay tuned for my trailer reaction to Slayer 3. Until next time.